This video is brought to you by Brilliant. Okay, so aside being weirdly recognized as James McAvoy, the second most popular comment on the channel in recent weeks is in regards to my calendar widget that I use on my iPhone. This is a Widgie widget that I created myself, which unfortunately, even though I placed links for, many are still struggling to acquire and keep asking me about it. So with that much interest, I figured it would be best if I show you how to make your own calendar widget like I did in that particular video, and then spice it up a bit to make it even cooler. Creating this widget is actually very, very simple, but I understand intimidation, so I'll go slow and step by step showing you how you can create and customize your own calendar widget. So download Widgie widget and let's get right to it. Open Widgie widget. In the first tab, Create, click on the top green button with a plus sign called Create. Now, we are going to be creating a medium widget size, so click on the medium size to begin. Creating a Widgie widget might seem a bit intimidating at first, but it's actually very intuitive and simple to use. Everything is based on layers, just like in an image editing app. To understand how the fundamental controls work, let me give you a quick example. Let's say I want to add a simple text. From the Layers panel, all I have to do is select Add New Layer and choose Text. Now I have a blank text layer. As soon as I do that, I am immediately placed inside the settings of the layer that I just created. If I go back, I go to the Main Layers tag. If I click on the text layer, I go inside where I can tweak it to my liking. The very basic controls that you're going to use are the positioning arrows and the size arrows. I can increase and reposition my text layer according to my liking. If I go through my settings tab, you'll see that I have the option to change the font, color, background, effects, and more. And these are the basics. By the way, if you end up enjoying this video, subscribe, because why not? Now that you are aware of the basics, let's create our awesome widget calendar, exactly the same one that I've used in my ultimate iPhone home screen setup video. In case you haven't seen that video, I'll be sure to link it at the end of this one. What you need to know about this particular widget is that the weekly calendar is actually a pre-built template that we just need to summon and tweak visually to our liking. So to do that, we click on Add New Layer and scroll down to the calendar. Once we add the calendar, the first thing that we see is the default Gregorian full month calendar. Now you can stop there and use that if you like, but in the case of my needs and in the video that we're talking about, I want a weekly calendar only. So to change the type of calendar, all you have to do is enable compact mode and boom, we are 90% closer to what we want to do. On the top row, we have the weekdays followed by a divider line and the dates below. Let's have some fun and start with some customization. The first thing that I'd like to do is to adjust the positioning a bit. I want to give it a bit of space on the top and on the bottom. With the help of the control arrows, I can just do that. Next, I want to change the font and the spacer or divider to match my style. A narrower font with some nice colors. I'll choose the spacer to be an orange color, and I'll choose the day names color to be something warmer. Then I'll scroll down and I'll leave the remaining day colors to be white, with the exception of Sunday, which I'll make sure to be something like reddish pink. Finally, I'll change the default system font on both the dates and the days to something that looks sleeker, like Bebas or something else, for example. To make the calendar stand out, no matter what wallpaper I use, I'll give it a shadow. To create the right shadow, I'll first give the calendar a sample background in order to see the shadow as I create it. I'll make the shadow black and position a bit to the right and a bit to the bottom to be casted at an angle, not straight behind the text. Basically, I'm offsetting it by 2 in both the X and Y axis. Finally, I'll reduce the shadow opacity from 100% visible to, let's say, alpha 55%. Next, I can change the current date circle to be something else. The circle is actually a round symbol that is used, so I can pretty much choose whatever I like a star or something else. I think an oval shape looks good. I'll give that shape a color, and with all that, as soon as I hit the main back arrow on the top left, I will be confirming my changes and the calendar widget will be complete. If we try to add it to our homepage, however, you'll notice that it is nowhere to be found. The reason for that is because it's not assigned to a specific slot. See, with Widget Widget, you have 8 empty slots for every available widget size. You can create all sorts of widgets and assign them to the slots and place them around iOS as you see fit. To assign the widget to an empty slot, all you have to do is go to the Manage tab and click on an empty medium slot to assign it. It might ask you to assign a theme to it, but you can ignore that prompt for now. Okay, so now you can go to Widgets and find the one you created. But wait! It doesn't have a transparent background. Let's fix that quickly. Go to your newly created widget and click on Edit. To add a transparent background, we have to place an empty background container behind it, sort of like a dummy image. Click on Add New Layer and select Image. Be sure to stretch that image to the full width and height of the widget. Once you do that, go to the Image section of the menu, go to the last option, Widget, and choose Transparent Background High Quality. Finally, to blend the background, we have to take a screenshot of our current home screen to help Widget render that background behind the calendar. Go to Jiggle Mode on the iPhone as if you're about to move around apps. Scroll right to an empty home screen where you have no widgets and apps and take a screenshot. Make sure you've chosen the right wallpaper first. I'm currently enjoying my latest Blurred Lines version 2 pack, which I'll link in the cards and in the description below. In fact, if you're looking for an abstract, unobtrusive wallpaper, I have a very good collection of wallpaper packs, which you can browse on my website. So, once you have the screenshot of your setup, go to Widget, and in the Manage tab, click on Set Transparent Background. Here, you can add the background or the screenshot that you took for both the light and dark modes of your iPhone. And guess what? We are done. Well, almost. An additional step that you might want to take is to add a new touch action layer on top of the calendar layer that will make the widget clickable and trigger to open your actual calendar app. From Add New Layers, scroll down and select Tap Action Layer. Position that layer across the calendar, and in the Action tab, go to Apple's Apps and choose the Calendar app. And there you go, this is the calendar widget that I've been using in my latest videos. Controlling the layers in Widget Widget's grid using the positioning and sizing inputs reminds me of a robot vacuum cleaner grid and Brilliant's course on Introduction to Probability. The lesson on simulation that I currently took involved grids and a cute little vacuum robot called Broombot. Through simulation, the course helped me understand random processes using a simulator where conventional analysis would be too difficult to break through. Probability is the business of decision making in the face of uncertainty, whether it's forecasting the future or inferring the past. Like the probability course, Brilliant provides other courses for ambitious people of all ages that replace lecture videos with hands-on interactive problem solving. It is a versatile tool that allows you to learn at your own pace and on the go. Build confidence and take advantage of Brilliant by following the first link in the description below or visiting brilliant.org/thisisee, and the first 200 people to upgrade with my link will get 20% off the annual premium subscription. Now let's spice things a bit. I want to create a calendar widget that also has an integrated weather information showcasing me what it currently feels like outside. Now I'll breeze through this setup since you should be understanding the fundamentals by now. First, I'll shrink down the calendar widget that we just created and push it to the right, leaving about 2 quadrants empty on the left. In them, I'll first add a new symbol layer. From the symbols icons, I'll go to Smart Symbols and find the Now Weather icons. These are basically smart icons that change based on the weather information. Right now it's sunny, but if it's cloudy or raining, that will change accordingly. I'll choose the current filled out weather icon and position it in place. I might give it a subtle color to match the calendar on the right. Once I'm done, I'll add a new layer, which I'll use to visualize the current temperature. In the settings of the text layer, I'll go to the very last option, which is the Data tab, and I'll tell that layer to be a dynamic one, reading the current temperature. I'll choose Weather Now and select the Feels Like temperature. I'll turn off Show Unit to have just the digits of the temperature. Then I'll go back to visualize that temperature as I see fit. I'll add a little circle symbol with a similar thickness to my temperature font to represent the degree symbol, and finally, I'll also add a tiny basic text that reads feels like, and I'll place it as a divider between the weather icon and the temperature. The rest of the setup is moving around things and making tiny adjustments and spacings to make sure everything looks balanced and good. An additional step might be to place a tap action layer above my weather portion of the widget that will lead me to my weather app, and with that, the super clean and useful widget is complete. Be sure to check out my full iPhone home screen setup video here, as well as my iPad episode to find how I use combination of clever widgets, shortcuts and focus modes to maximize the potential of my devices. Give this video a like and subscribe, and as always, it's been an absolute pleasure. This is Z, over and out.